Mr. Marwah is the CEO of Sector Skill Council for Food Processing Industries, a non-profit co-promoted by FICCI and NSDC. Prior to this, he has also held senior management positions at JK Lakshmi Cement and Dabur Ayurved. Mr. Marwah, are you online?
Yes, thank you very much.
Okay, please begin.
I would like to thank you for giving me this opportunity to come and speak about something which we are doing in the skilling domain, which is job-oriented as well as which is for creation of entrepreneurship. As we all know, a little background I like to give that agriculture is quite strong in India, but we know very well that there is a lot of food stuff which goes waste. We know very well that we have moved away from an era of shortages to era of surpluses. When we read about milk being thrown on the streets of Pune or in Maharashtra or in Punjab, we know very well that there is lack of demand. So the solution to that problem is to sustain agriculture. And to sustain agriculture is very important to have processing of agriculture produce. And frankly speaking, it is not something which is unique in the world, because in many of the industrialized countries, 80% of the output is converted into something which is more, which has a longer shelf life, which is more marketable. But in India, it is very low, and you'd be surprised that the highest processing is happening in dairy sector thanks to the Amul and the NDDB initiative. Considering that, we are at about 12-15% conversion. So everything is basically going fresh into the wet market, and as a result, the farmer is not able to realize his income. There is wastage of resources, and we find that we can do more with less. But currently, we are living in a luxurious situation that we are wasting a lot of agriculture produce. So the answer really, next slide. So the answer really is to have a vibrant food processing sector, and this has already started in India, which is about $600 billion, and it is growing quite rapidly. It is a sunrise sector. There are lots of people who are coming forward to start up because it has a lot of opportunities. There is a lot of potential in the food processing to double the farmer's income, and you'd be happy to know that it has a huge employment opportunity, because broadly speaking, this is divided into two parts. One is the organized sector, where you see highly branded companies who are part of FMCG, who are employing about 18 lakh people. But overall, there are about 70 lakh persons, out of which 15 lakh are women. Most of the employment is in home enterprises, nano enterprises, small enterprises, and therefore there is a huge opportunity for rural folk to move away from agriculture to something more industrial. It is an opportunity for the women to get to do something near their home rather than migration. You see, one of the challenges which we face in our society is that the men can migrate, need to migrate to get jobs, but women can't, and women normally don't migrate. So what is that we can do for them in their local area? So primary processing is definitely something which they can start in an agrarian economy, and slowly they can build up. Now, primary processing is what? Simple things like grading, sorting, packing. We're not even doing that. We are selling everything all together, which means that you have the potatoes of various sizes going all together, so price realization is lower. And if we segregate grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, which is happening in Maharashtra, very largely Gujarat, but not in many other parts. So simple occupations can be started, and slowly it can be built up. There are other value added products which can be made by these rural enterprises, which would be that can add to the local income of the farmer and of the community. Next slide. Now, I would like to talk about entrepreneurship because I think the youth and the women in the rural areas are really looking for alternatives. What are the things they can do other than farming? Frankly, land is shrinking. There's not much of land available. Even if land is available, there's a lot of time. So they are looking for what they can do. And I would like to advocate entrepreneurship in food processing because you can start it with any amount of capital. You can start it with 50,000 rupees as a home enterprise, or you can do for 10 lakh rupees. You need to, it's a highly demand-driven sector. It is unlikely that in any district, there is no demand for processed food items. Bread is one important item. Biscuits, pickles, these are heavily local demand. So you don't really need to make large quantities to export it, to send it to other districts. You can take care of your local requirement by producing these products with the least amount of investment, yet able to produce some value and some income for your family. It can be done by on a family level as well, where the women will do this work, but men can go and sell. How they go and sell is a simple cycle with a trunk at the back, which has all these items, and they can go door to door selling or supply to kirana stores. Ultimately, it can generate an income for the family. And when we are directly dealing with the producer and the consumer, it will give ultimately better profit margin. I would prefer that some of these entrepreneurs don't go to kirana stores and pay 30% markup. It would be much better if they can supply directly to families. Next point. Next slide, please. Now, in all this, what is happening is India is aptly suited for food processing because we are the largest producer in the world for milk, pulses, cashew nuts, very large producer of spices, poultry. Poultry has become a very big item. It has become very, very important now. Livestock, fish. It is a huge consumer base. The strong economy, which means you have acting at things like noodles, pastas, they feel like biscuits, breads. So it's not that only the urban folk are looking at some diversion from their routine dal roti or rice chawal or rice dal. They're also looking at something different once in a while. So aptly, this particular area needs focus and attention. Let's move further. But what is required is that there has to be a spirit of entrepreneurship, which means one or two or three can form an SHG, can be family enterprise, but there has to be a unique idea, something different. We need to find the market for that and get finance. Financing is one of the important reasons why enterprises fail. Right now, there's a lot of scope because of the Mudra loans and other loans which are there. The Shishu Mudra loan is very simple to get. There is also the fact that you need to get into a supply chain management. You need to connect up with your suppliers as well as they should know how to buy their product. Unless it's backward integration, which means that you are actually producing something and then you're converting that, which is very rare. So if they are into manufacturing of any, say, bread, they should know where to buy maida, where to buy the various ingredients. So that purchasing part is also very important, which they need to know, and regulatory compliances related to packaging, etc. Move forward, please. Next slide. There are a whole lot of areas which I've put here, and I think all of you are familiar with. There's nothing that is new here. It's kind of food which we are consuming, but it can also be done at the district level, at the farm gate. Move forward, please. What do we need in this particular situation? We are basically looking at people who have got innovation, people who are good at marketing, people who are good at understanding. So all those things have to be taken into account. You should have been able to manage some simple technology, should understand food technology, should have business development skills and management skills. Next point. I've also covered part of it here, but we must understand that food safety is very important, and at the micro level, that is what is the biggest challenge. Well, people may be able to produce goods, may be able to produce food of a particular quality, but the environment in which it is produced, the production, how it is undertaken, the cleanliness, the hygiene, all those factors are very important for the food business operator, and that is what the government also wants, because ultimately what they produce goes into the food chain, and that can affect the lives and health of many, many people. So while entrepreneurship in food is something which we want to do, but it has to be with that underlying thing that food safety and hygiene is most important. Move next slide, please. We are engaged in skilling, and we create manpower for micro enterprises as well as for big industrial undertakings. We are taking care of basically skilling so that we are able to give them the relevant skill set so that they can start their business or they can take care of their the job. We also provide them with the quality and regulatory requirements, and this is ultimately when we invest in workforce, we also help significantly to increase the productivity. At this point in time, the biggest challenge is create the skilling infrastructure. Food processing is extremely important for the economy, but the centers or the colleges or the institutions which are taking care of skilling are very few. You have degree colleges, people to everybody can't go and do a B.Tech. So that is one big challenge. Move forward, please. Next slide. So we as Sector Skill Council in Food Processing, short form being FICCI, our major job is to create an ecosystem wherein we are creating the entire infrastructure. So we have at this point in time about 100 centers, which is not sufficient. 100 centers which are spread all over the country in various parts where these courses are being provided under the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. In addition to that, we have also we do a lot of trainings for FSSAI, which is the Food Safety Standards Authority of India. We help people to get jobs. We have a job portal. We have online training academy also. And we certify the students who do our courses under the Skill India Initiative so that they are able to seek employment in different parts of the country. It's not necessarily that they are limited to one particular area, so they can move to different areas. And finally, I would like to say that, next line. Finally, I would like to say that we have to become, in fact, in food processing, we have to become more relevant. And the relevance will come only if we are able to create curriculum which matters. And that's what we are addressing. So we create the content, the curriculum in Hindi, English and other languages. We create the manpower who can take on the training of these students in various parts of the country. We help training centers to be set up. We also like to bring in new technologies and new thought from leading institutions like NIFTM and IFPT. And we are very happy to work with the private sector also, who would like us to be the knowledge partner in implementing food processing programs under the CSR. As you know very well, that a lot of focus has gone on other areas, whether it is apparel, whether it is web designing and data entry, but not much of work has happened in food processing and organizing. So we can be the knowledge partners. We can help you to put down a program to meet your objectives so that you are able to realize those objectives very clearly. We can undertake audits of the trainings, how they are conducted after the trainers have been trained, and we can assess the students, and ultimately the student gets a skill certificate. So we can add value to the CSR funds, and in turn food processing can also help the growth of the economy of the rural areas. Next slide. So I think what is important is coming together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. Working together is success. So we are looking forward to working with the industry and creating livelihood for the rural areas, and also helping the economy to save some of the food stuff which is going waste. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Marwa, for sharing the insights, especially about strengthening the farm and non-farm linkages and how it can provide not only alternate source of income, but also in turn contribute to enhancing the farm-based livelihoods of rural areas. So we have a couple of questions for you. The first question is, what is the support that your organization can provide to nonprofits and local agencies to build capacities, especially in local food processing and market linkages? Are there any structured capacity building programs for the same?
See, we are a skilling organization. So what we do is we help make a skilling program which is relevant for a particular area. We can help create the infrastructure which is required for that. We can also help getting funds from the government. There are subsidy funds available for setting up skilling centers. That can be done. We train the trainers and certify the trainers so that the people who take up the curriculum have the right kind of profile. And finally, we also do the assessment of the student and award the skill certificate. If they want jobs, we have a job portal where they can be provided the facility of placement assistance. And when it comes to the loans and setting up, we are having facilitating organizations who would do this to help people raise finances, help people connect with the market. And we in turn limit ourselves to technology support, but we have subject matter experts who can help the entrepreneur to pick up the right equipment, to understand the quality standards and really help them to improve and streamline their production processes. But we are not directly into marketing as of now. For that, we have facilitated organizations who do it on our behalf.